the drama falls out.
Okay, like jump in there.
No, I gotta ask you this, Mikey.
Yesterday you had a chance. Like, maybe this morning. You and Keith Thurman spent a lot of time together.
Yeah, it was this morning.
Tell everybody.
We had the episode this morning with Abner and with Keith. You know, he mentioned, he asked some questions about, you know, my fight, of course. And, you know, early on, he was obviously saying that, you know, he thinks Spence's size would, you know, outmatch me. But like I said, I believe my skills are better, and they still haven't seen it. And that's what I'm betting on.
You didn't talk smack. Spence didn't talk smack, which is very rare. Both of you guys are undefeated. Both of you guys on a pound-for-pound list.
Look, Spence knows it's not going to be an easy fight either. He knows it's a big, challenging fight for him. He's never faced someone like me with my skill level. You know, and he respects that. I respect him. But like I said, his fighting resembles and reminds me of myself a lot. Does everything well. You know, doesn't have anything flashy, crazy out of this world, you know, a skill like that. But everything is done well. But I still believe I'm better than him. You know, just by a little bit, just a little bit more. So he showed me respect, I showed him respect. But hey, once we get inside the ring, there's no respect. I'm gonna do whatever I gotta do to win, you know?
You did that for your father. We get five division champions.
Look, my dad had always mentioned that he would like to have a multiple division champion, and you know, he thought maybe 3-4 divisions. Well, I wanna get another one, you know, give him something extra than he ever expected. But you know, it's just great, you know, to be able to do this. While my dad is here, my brother in the corner, you know, sharing these moments with him in the corner, with my nephew. I mean, there's no greater feeling than that.
Mikey, you were so dominant, the 120s, the 130s. Last time I talked to you, I mean, this is the last time, a couple times, you have moved up a weight class and you were a little nervous about it. Now it's two weight classes, but you don't seem nervous about this at all. You were a little tentative that first time.
Look, being that it were a year ago, we were moving up to 140, you know, it was a little daunting at first, you know, because we're fighting a very strong guy, you know, very difficult guy. But after overcoming that, that gives me the confidence that I can do it even more. And that's what we're moving up to welterweight, you know, against another undefeated champion, very strong, very risky fight, very dangerous. But, you know, I have the confidence because I know my boxing skills will help me prevail.
Which is what you keep saying, that you have the skills that can overcome this. What I want to talk about is you, where you're from, your family, because it's such a great story. Your brother was a boxing champion, your father a trainer, you grew up in Oxnard. Tell everybody a little bit where you went to school, you went to the Olympics.
Look, we started my amateur career at 14. Then I went through high school in Pacifica High School in Oxnard. You know, and I was in the amateur program at that time. You know, and I still didn't dream of being where I am, you know. And if we go further back, you know, as a kid, I used to go to the gym with my dad and my brother, but again, just to go fool around, never even picked up the gloves to train. You know, I was a young kid, just being a kid, you know, playing with all of my friends. That was it, you know, and little by little, I started to, you know, box more, and it grew on me, and, you know, now we're in the biggest fight of boxing, you know, for the year, and, you know, the most anticipated boxing match, you know, the biggest stage I could ever imagine, you know. I said it was never a dream for me to be here, but destiny, you know, has something different for you, and you know, I'm very happy to be where I am.
You know, your brother seemed a little bit nervous or tentative about this move up, and I can imagine that happening. He's 100% in your corner. He talks about you like he is you. You know, he's part of this. But what did he say to you when you said, "I want to go after Old Spence"?
Look, my brother and my dad both. You know, at first they didn't take me serious, they didn't think I was serious, just like everybody else in the world. You know, they didn't believe I was really willing to move up to welterweight. But this happened a little over a year ago that I first mentioned, you know, the jump up. I knew I had to take care of other fights first.
Like, wait. Yeah, you can't just say, I first mentioned it. I want to know what the conversation in the room was like. Were you looking at video and you said, hey, to your brother, I'm going to take him? What was the moment?
Like, I was watching one of his fights, actually. We were watching him and Peterson. It was a good fight. But I told Robert, you know, after this, I'll go up to 140. I'll fight, you know, Spence. And he just laughed. This is what we're talking about. Well, you're lightweight. You know, you're fighting at 140, just, you know, this opportunity, but you're coming back down to lightweight. So, nah, I want to make things different. I want to change things up. I want to get up there and, you know, take him out. Not just any fight at, you know, at welterweight. I want to fight him.
Okay. I understand your brother might be like, okay, but when you told your dad or he told your dad?
I told my dad.
Okay, when you told your dad, did your dad
say I was crazy? Estás loco.
Mm-hmm.
What for? I mean, there's no need to do that, you know. You're fighting wild at 135, you know, you're fighting at 140 even. That's fine, you know, just do that. said, nah, I want to challenge them. I got more in me that people still haven't seen. You know, and I need these kinds of fights to bring it out of me.
Yeah, let's also shout out Robert Garcia. We're in the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy.
He's watching. He's watching.
Hi, Robert. Robert, come here. Where is he?
Come on,
come
in,
on in here, Robert, because we love it. I wanted to meet your brother. Here. He's hiding.
He's an amazing trainer. And that's why, Mikey, he might be going up 2 weight classes. But boxing and angles and technique and strategy, which he gets from his brother, which he gets since he was a little kid, I think that's what you can bring to this fight. And I said it all along, Mikey, you are the best pound-for-pound boxer right now, and you can prove it with a win that's coming soon.
I think so, too. You know, I've told everybody, you know, it takes a lot more than just weight and size to win a boxing match, you know? And I have all those skills. You know, I got the best
check over up there,
I got the best footwork. I got the best skills overall. And that's what I'm